Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome back. Call of Duty Next officially begins tomorrow, which means we are going to be getting so much information in regard to MW3, including zombies, Warzone, multiplayer, and yes, even Warzone Mobile, which isn't attached, but kind of is. There's going to be a lot of videos coming out tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. But before we get to that point, there's a couple of different things that I wanted to let you know. First and foremost, if you digitally pre-ordered Modern Warfare 3, you are now able to download the beta. Modern Warfare 2, the application on PlayStation, has now transformed into just Call of Duty. This is essentially going to be the HQ for all Call of Duty games moving forward. So if you're on the PlayStation, at least, all you gotta do is press start over the application, go to manage your content, and then scroll down until you see the Modern Warfare 3 beta to force start it. On PlayStation, it's around 25 gigs, and on Xbox, I can't really tell you. I've had a couple people saying that they've gotten lucky, it's shown up there, but it's a 30 gig download. I couldn't even begin to tell you how to do it there, but at least on the PlayStation, you can force start it by going through the manage content screen. Now, otherwise, if you didn't want to do this, you could just wait a couple of days, and I'm sure the day before or the day of, you'll be able to have it just automatically begin if you digitally pre-ordered it. For physical pre-orders, you should be receiving a download code via your email, so just keep an eye out for that. Now, the next thing I want to talk about are some new in-game rewards that we're going to be able to get. These, however, are exclusive to Modern Warfare 3 and will not be shared with MW2. During Call of Duty Next, for all of us that are back home watching live, we'll be able to get a weapon blueprint, an emblem, charm, and calling card just for tuning in. I'd like to believe that all of these things are going to be usable during the beta, but if it's not, at least they'll be there at launch. And honestly, it's not a bad batch of items. I personally like the charm, and even the blueprint looks pretty cool. I'm excited to get in-game and start using these for myself, and hopefully they'll be usable during the beta, very similar to what we saw last year with the pre-order items for Modern Warfare 2. So the good news this time around is there's no specific preference to where you need to watch. You can actually be on YouTube or Twitch. As long as your Activision account is linked, you'll be able to watch and earn. The next thing I'd like to discuss is the PlayStation exclusive Combat Pack 6, aka Shogun. This has officially released today, and as long as you have PlayStation Plus on PS4 or PS5, you can add this to your library for free. This includes an operator skin for Oni, of course, no big surprise there. Oni was the exclusive PlayStation operator and basically the vehicle to drive these exclusive packs no one else gets access to. You get two weapon blueprints, a charm, sticker, calling card, and an emblem, all of which is accompanied by a final finishing move called Bloody Percussionist, and this is what that looks like. The blueprints honestly don't look too bad either. They just kind of break the integrity of the mastery camo because of the way it is. And the outfit, by the way, really does remind me of a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. I don't know why. I think it's just the way the backpack is. It reminds me of a shell. Combined with the body armor on the front, yeah, it just kind of reminds me of a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. Not necessarily the worst thing. It's a cool looking outfit. Don't get me wrong. It's gold and green, but overall, a very interesting choice indeed. If this is not appearing on your PlayStation Store, by the way, try restarting your console and just look up in the search area Warzone Combat Pack, and it should be one of the first things that ends up popping up under add-ons. And I just want to point something out. I think after the Modern Warfare 3 beta and this initial exclusivity, and of course this Shogun pack that we just got done talking about, I believe this is the end of exclusivity. I don't think there's anything coming moving forward unless there's another deal slated to happen in 2024 with Treyarch's game, but I highly doubt that that's happening. I am kind of excited to see what happens with content parity. Phil Spencer has already gone on record by stating they're not going to be doing any exclusives, but then again, I'm kind of curious if there's anything still just lingering that has to be taken care of before they fully take over Activision Blizzard. I don't think there is. So I just wanted to point out, I think this is it for exclusivity. This and the Modern Warfare 3 beta early access. And after that, I think everybody's playing on the same day. No packs that will be coming through that aren't already shared with both games. No 30-day exclusivity, nothing like that. Unless Microsoft goes back on their word, which I guess is entirely possible. Unless that's added in a contract somewhere that I'm just not aware of. But anyway, that's it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Big thank you for watching this video here today. I will have a ton of information coming your way tomorrow with Call of Duty Next. I'm looking forward to covering it right here from home. Unfortunately, I did not get an invite this year, but that is okay. I don't think I would have been able to go anyway, so it just kind of works out better this way in terms of creating content for all of you and reacting on my own terms. So thank you guys for watching. Drop a like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more, and I'll see you all tomorrow for Call of Duty Next coverage. Peace.